स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर के सी ओए, फैकल्टी ऑफ शांतिराम कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्माकोलॉजी. नेक्स्ट अवर टॉपिक इज रीनल फिजियोलॉजी. रीनल, वाई इट इज कॉल्ड रीनल? बिकॉज ऑफ द नेफ्रॉन कंसिस्ट ऑफ रीनल ट्यूब्स, दैट्स वाई इट इज रीनल. And the main function it is happening in the renal tubes, that's why it is called as renal physiology. That functions are filtration, reabsorption, secretion and excretion. So these are the renal functions. So everybody know that body fluids contains 60% of the body weight and 40% solid material, bones and other tissue materials. So in that 60% intracellular fluid 40%, extracellular fluid 20%. Intracellular fluid, the fluid present in cell. Extracellular fluid, the fluid present outside of the cell. In that again the extracellular fluid we can divide to interstitial fluid, plasma. Interstitial fluid 15% and plasma 5%. Interstitial fluid, that fluid between the one cell and another cell. The plasma present in blood. So for example, if you take in a person 70 kg, that person it intake whatever it is, water, food, water, in that food also it water it will be there. So whatever it is taken, so this is up to here, this is extracellular, this is intracellular. See, this is 14 liters present, this is 28 liters total. So how much it will come? 42 liters. So exact in that 70 kg, 60% of water present. So in that again divided is a plasma 3.4 liters and 10.4. So in that this is the case. If the person, if it taken as a 70 kg, this much of a fluid is present. This is input, this is output. So how the water is excreted? So through kidneys, the maximum amount of water excreted through kidneys, then after the lungs, then fecus, sweat, sweating nothing but through the skin. Then again, in that fluids, extracellular fluid, intracellular fluid, cations present, anions present. So what are the cations and what are the anions present? So in the intracellular fluid, this is intracellular fluid, the cations are potassium and magnesium. Potassium and magnesium ions only in the cell. And outside of the cell in cations, sodium and calcium. Then if you observe in the anions here, the no anions present in the intracellular. So the anions present in extracellular, that is chloride ions and bicarbonate ions, but the transport exchange takes place, that is the difference. So here also the transport exchange, one cell to another cell, that is a paracellular, intracellular, already we studied the transport mechanisms. So the maximum amount, here I am saying that maximum amount present. So why it is called potassium intracellular? The maximum amount of potassium present here. Why it is called intracellular magnesium? Why it is called intracellular? And because of maximum amount present here, that's why here I am saying that. So the maximum amount present here, if you take in chloride, maximum amount present in extracellular, but few amount will automatically from one cell to another cell, it is transport is takes place. These are very, very important. So the sodium, calcium or extracellular cations and chloride and bicarbonate are anions. The potassium is and magnesium intracellular ions. So already we discussed about the organization of urinary system, kidneys, ureters, bladders, urethra and how it is takes place. And the functions, if you take in the main urinary system, homeostasis to maintain the blood always to single condition. So by the, so that's why urinary system to maintain acid-base balance. At the same time, it enhances the production of erythropoietin in the bone marrow. Erythropoietin is a hormone to produce the RBC in the bone marrow and regulation of vitamin D in our body. So these are the functions. Sir, already we said that function, the renal, that is renal tubules doing the physiology mechanism. That physiology mechanism enhance this. Our physiology lo renal tubules avidanga panacheyatam valane mana body lo acid balance maintain, acid base balance maintain avutundi. Erythropoietin hormone secrete avutundi, vitamin D kuda secrete avutundi. Fine. So already you know we studied entire these things. So renal papillary sprint, renal calyx 78, major calyx. Already we studied, already last video we studied this entire thing. This is one of the important because structure. The nephrons, depending upon the location, they divided a cortical nephron and juxtamedullary nephron, which are present in cortex, that especially the location, that's we can call cortical nephron. So in the kidney, the most nephrons present in cortical region, the very few only present in juxtamedullary. This is the important. This is a renal corpuscle. This is a capsule. This is the Bowman capsule. This is a corpuscle. That is the difference between the Bowman capsule and the corpuscle. The corpuscle, it is made up of blood vessels. Afferent arteriole connected with the efferent arteriole. This is only it is made up of blood vessels. So this is the what is happening, what is the structure and loop of NL, and what is it is made loop of NL, already we studied. This is collecting tubules. So this is for the structure. This is a juxtaglomerular apparatus. This is afferent arteriole. This is capsule. This is glomerular capillaries, that is glomerular corpuscle, glomerular capillary corpuscle, or also we can call glomerular capillaries. Okay, so here this is Bowman capsule, just to glomerular apparatus. We can discuss in this renal physiology how it is this entire it will come. So on the overview we can discuss about how the urine formation and how it is reabsorption, secretion and how urine it is formed in the renal tubules we can discuss here, and how it is regulated. The process of urine formation through the ultrafiltration, selective reabsorption, secretion and excretion. Ultrafiltration takes place in glomerulus, nothing but corpuscles. Selective reabsorption, it is happen in the renal tubules, proximal convoluted tubule, distal convoluted tubules and collecting ducts. secretion also it is takes place in renal tubules, and excretion takes place blocks to collecting ducts. So this is the way how I said. So we can discuss one by one. So filtration, it is takes place here in the renal glomerulus corpuscle. It is mainly through the difference between the pressure in afferent arterial diameter is more when compared to the efferent arterial. This is afferent arterial, just you observe here also, this is afferent arterial when compared this diameter more, this diameter is less. So due to this, more accumulation of blood here and also created pressure. It also pedda pipe nunchi chinna pipe ki velthunnappudu automatically pressure increase avutundi. So ikkada more blood accumulate ay filtration of, so that is hydrostatic pressure created. Then after that reabsorption takes place, we can see so many is there. See this filtration. So blood pressure forces small molecules from the glomerulus to the capsule. So when that blood forces in the glomerulus filtrate, what are filtrate? Glucose filtrated, amino acids filtrated, uric acids filtrated, urea and ions, all ions are filtrated. So ikkadiki ivanni vachese water, urea, glucose, amino acids, salts nothing but all sodium, potassium, calcium, all entered in the lumen of the tubule. That is the filtration due to blood pressure that created by the hydrostatic pressure. Then after that reabsorption, return of filtrate from blood at the proximal tubule through the diffusion or active transport. After filtration through the diffusion, that is passive diffusion from high concentration to low concentration, it is entered into the veins. So that is through the diffusion. Passive diffusion is which have the small molecules, they are easily diffusion takes place, which have the large molecules, for example glucose, amino acid, they are through the active transport they are diffused or transported to the veins. So tubular secretion, so movement of molecules from blood into the distal convoluted tubules. Why I say that distal convoluted tubules? Because of the most the maximum the secretion takes place in distal convoluted. Secretion means here whatever the blood contains any extra items, nothing but extra items, here is extra molecules, if it is present in blood, they are secreted into the distal convoluted tubules. That molecules, drugs or toxins or some other ions, if it is more concentration in the blood, they are secreted into the distal convoluted tubules as well as collected ducts. So these are the most sites for the secretion, tubular secretion. So in collecting duct, some more again the return of water via osmosis. You know the osmosis, it is a low concentration to high concentration. So here the more water again it is entering to the here, and so again reabsorption takes place. Already we defined the process of glomerular filtrate, reabsorption and secretion. So the processing of glomerular filtration is the movement of fluid and ions from the blood to sorry from the tubules to fluid. Why it is called reabsorption? Already the absorption takes place in intestine. Ante manam edaithe food gaani water gaani edaithe teeskunnamo first absorption anedi intestine lo jarigindi. Ippudu kidney lo filtration jarigindi. Kidney lo filtration jarigin tarvata aa filtrate ainatuvanti malli blood lo kostunayi. Ante intestine lo first absorption cheskunna tarvata blood lo kellindi aa blood किडनी लो के लेंदी किडनी लो फिल्ट्रेशन जरिगिंदी फिल्ट्रेशन जरिगिंदी वेंटने दट फिल्ट्रेशन अगेन अब्जॉर्प्शन टेक्स प्लेस इन रीनल ट्यूबल्स फ्रम रीनल ट्यूबल्स लो उन्नटुवंटि सेल्स उंटाई कदा अब्जॉर्प्शन चेसुकुंटाई आ अब्जॉर्प्शन ने द ट्यूबुलर अब्जॉर्प्शन री अब्जॉर्प्शन सो वाई आर ट्यूबुलर सेल्स द ट्रांसेल्युलर सेल्स इदी वाई आर द ट्यूबुलर सेल्स ने ट्रांसेल्युलर सेल्स अंटाम ట్రాన్సెల్యులర్ రూట్ అంటే సెల్ ద్వారా వెళ్ళేది అని సో అది దట్ ఈజ్ బిట్వీన్ ది సెల్స్ ఆల్సో హ్యాపెన్ దాన్నే ఉంటుంటే పారాసెల్యులర్ రూట్ వీ కెన్ డిస్కస్ మీకు ఒక డయాగ్రామ్ ఉంది వీ కెన్ అండర్స్టాండ్ వాట్ ఈస్ హ్యా వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ సో సెక్రీషన్ సెక్రీట్ అవడం ఫ్రమ్ ది బ్లడ్ టు ట్యూబుల్స్ సో విచ్ హ్యావ్ ది మోర్ కాన్సన్ట్రేటెడ్ ఇన్ ది బ్లడ్ either ions either drugs either toxin substance they are secreted into the tubules from the blood to tubules that is called as that is happen through two routes so transcellular route and paracellular route so in the filtration already I said that amino acids glucose all ions are filtrated in the reabsorption this is overall diagram in the reabsorption the main water తీసుకున్నట్లయితే the 65% of water reabsorption in the proximal convoluted tubules proximal convoluted tubules and 15% the reabsorption takes place in the collecting loop of canal and remaining whatever it is there it takes place nothing but a distal convoluted and collecting duct 19% of water reabsorption takes place. This is only for the regarding water reabsorption. So this is the proximal convoluted tubules 65%. And how the which are reabsorption takes place? Water, glucose, amino acids, sodium chloride, bicarbonate, and potassium ions. These are all reabsorption takes place. So this is a cell structure under reabsorption takes place. So why the major amount of proximal convoluted is a reabsorption site? Because of extensive brush border, the proximal epithelial cells have extensive number of carrier proteins. In the proximal convoluted tubules, the glucose transporters, amino acid transporters are more number and epithelials have extensive number. That's why the carrier proteins here nothing but the glucose transporters. The transport is made up of protein. That's why it is a carrier protein. And proximal convoluted tubules have a large number of mitochondria. So if the more mitochondria, more energy production. If the more energy production, the cells are more active. So that's why the more reabsorption site is proximal convoluted tubules. This is the eyelid said that 65 whatever the if you take an 100% filtration in that 65% filtered sodium and water reabsorbed with the proximate convoluted tube, and the most chloride ions also reabsorbed in proximate convoluted tubules. And what secretions takes place in proximate convoluted tubules? Only organic acids and base. Examples are urate salts, bile salts, bilirubin, bilirubin. So these are all secreted in the proximate convoluted tubule, but it is very small amount only, not a maximum amount. Bile salts, oxalate, urate and catecholamine secrete. So small amount, very small amount only secretion takes place in the proximal convoluted tubules. The major amount secretion takes place in the distal convoluted tubules and collecting ducts. This is oral graph. See, after filtration of filtration, even filtrate in Japan, sodium, potassium, chloride ions, magnesium, so all ions, glucose, amino acids, and other few proteins. After filtration, the reabsorption through the two routes, transcellular route and paracellular route. Transcellular route or path we can call as this is filtration. After filtration, this is lumen. So through the cell, through the cell we can call it as a transcellular. Paracellular means between one cell to another cell, that is a paracellular. This is a blood vessel and it reached into the capillary. These capillary, sir, so where it is present? See, here it is present. These efferent arteriole, it is divided into small blood vessels. So that person again can reach. So that after filtration, whatever the ions and glucose and amino acids transported through the transcellular and paracellular into the blood. That what mechanism involved is diffusion or passive diffusion and active transport. So which have these small ions and small molecules, they are easily enter through the paracellular or small pores present in the cell, but large molecules, they are transported through the active transport by utilizing the, why it is called active transport, because of by they utilize the ATP energy. So glucose molecules and the proteins, so the some amino acids, so they are transported through the active transport. Between the cells, maximum one cell to another, the paracellular maximum, this is diffusion takes place, but in transcellular route only diffusion and active transport, but in between this paracellular route only diffusion. This is the diagram. So, in the proximal convoluted tubules, what are reabsorption? All glucose, lactate, amino acids, sodium, water, bicarbonate ion and chloride ions and potassium ions. These are most reabsorption takes place. So, all glucose, lactate, amino acids and most means maximum 65 to 70% reabsorption takes place here. These are all things, but and potassium very few amount. See, 65% and 90% bicarbonate ions, 50% Cl minus ions, 55% potassium ions. See here, this is lumen. Konjam reverse order ichara aa diagram ki diagram. So here the sodium ions and glucose amino acids directly through the carrier, glucose amino acids, some ions and vitamins, so through some carriers it is transported. So like that way is transported and enter into the blood. This is
calculation part. Again, same.
So reabsorption, this is regarding reabsorption of sodium. Reabsorption of sodium. This is regarding reabsorption of glucose through the by the secondary active transport enzyme, sodium glucose co-transport. Sodium potassium from transport sodium from the interim. So these are regarding reabsorption of glucose. See how it is. The glucose and transported here. Okay, this is the diagrams. I cannot discuss about here the voltage. You can get confusion. That's why I am telling simply how the reabsorption of glucose and sodium ions and amino acids. That is enough. This is how amino acids. The proteins are larger molecules, so these are why they are through the pinocytosis. Nothing but drinking. So once thus inside the cell, the proteins indigested into its constitutive amino acids, which are reabsorbed through the basolateral membrane into the interstitial fluid. So they are also reabsorbed through the pinocytosis. So this is the how the this is protein molecule. Suppose if you take it, so this it makes so like phagocytosis. How you study them? Same. It make engulfing. After engulfing, they are divided into in the cell. They are converted into amino acids. What you discussed here, after the formation of amino acid, they are reabsorbed. Simple. The reabsorption of sodium, the maximum it is through the sodium potassium pump transport. This is the mechanism involved. Again, the diagram. How the bicarbonate ions already. We discussed how the bicarbonic ions formed in the respiratory system. If you see my just watch my earlier video regarding regulation of respiration, in that I entirely discussed how the bicarbonate ions and bicarbonate it is formed. They are also reabsorbed. How it is formed and how it is reabsorbed. So, reabsorption of sodium. See, again repeated. So, this is a protein reabsorption. Repeated. Water reabsorption. It is happen in the loop of NL. Collecting drugs and distal convert intervals. Reabsorption of urea also takes place, but it's very small, very small amount only. Reabsorption of creatinine, very small amount only. These are already we discussed, that's why I'm not stressing about more matter on this. This is a transport maximum. These are examples and flow charts. Next, secretion. Through the secretion of H plus ions in the proximal convoluted tubules. For maintaining acid base balance. So by this way, see
the sodium is extracellular and potassium is intracellular. But here, by utilizing the ATP energy, the whatever the few amount present in, already said that the maximum amount it is present in extracellular, the sodium is maximum amount where it is present in extracellular, potassium intracellular. But here, by utilizing ATP energy to export sodium ions, to export sodium ions to the extracellular from intracellular to, just by utilizing ATP, potassium from extracellular to intracellular. For this maintaining, again what is happening, because of minus 70 millivolts, for maintaining minus 70 millivolts, normal resting potential of the cell, for maintaining this, the sodium ions influx takes place, H plus ions efflux takes place. That's why secretion of H plus ions into the lumen of the proximal convoluted tubules. These H plus ions again bind with the bicarbonate HCO3 minus and to form H2CO3. Then again, how these HCO3 minus ion formed in the cell, earlier we discussed in regulation of respiratory system. Just go through that video, we can understand easily. This is the way how the secretion of H plus ions. H plus is also secreted through the H plus pump in late distal convoluted and cortical collecting tubules. It is happening the proximal convoluted tubules, and the more, it is very few in proximal convoluted tubules, but the maximum amount it is distal convoluted tubules and collecting duct tubules. The maximum amount of secretion of H plus ions, or simply they can ask secretion of H plus ions, where it is H plus, if they given the distal convoluted tubules or collecting ducts, we have to give the first option, this. Some other para-amino, hippuric acid, also transport takes place. This is a descending loop of canal structure. So, in the descending loop of canal, the water reabsorption takes 20% of filtrate. 15% of reabsorption takes place, as I have discussed. Ascending loop of canal also water reabsorption along with the sodium and chloride ion. In thick ascending limb has the sodium / H plus antiport. The loop of canal reabsorption ascending. This is ascending, this is descending, this is ascending. Here, the sodium, I said that already, you know this point up to here. Here the sodium potassium antiport, This is also antiport. This is interstitial fluid between one cell to another cell. This is lumen, how it is secreted. Here, one more antiport is in the ascending loop of canal. Along with this, one more it is present is sodium, potassium, and chloride ion antiport. Actually, what is happening? Reabsorption of sodium ions to chloride ions and potassium ions. The normal mechanism is reabsorption of sodium, potassium, chloride ions takes place in the ascending loop of canal through the pump sodium, potassium to chloride ions. This is the pump, is a carrier protein. but
these are inhibited by loop diuretics. These are inhibited by loop diuretics. Why it is called loop diuretics? So the diuretics here to inhibit it, so their reabsorption not happen, though they excrete it. So reabsorption kaakokunte lumen lone adhe vidhanga excrete avutayi ante diuretic ante increases the urine output. ఎప్పుడైతే సోడియం పొటాషియం అండ్ క్లోరైడ్ అయాన్స్ ఎప్పుడైతే ఇవి రీఅబ్జార్ప్షన్ కావో వాటర్ కూడా రీఅబ్జార్ప్షన్ జరుగుతూ వై సార్ ఆల్వేస్ ద వాటర్ ఫాలోస్ ది సోడియం ఫాలో 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 యూ ద వాటర్ ఆల్వేస్ ఫాలో ది సోడియం సో ద సోడియం ఇట్ ఈస్ నీడ్ ద సోడియం నాట్ రీఅబ్జార్బ్డ్ దెన్ ఆటోమేటికల్లీ water also not reabsorbed in the loop of canal and distal convoluted tube. Distal convoluted tube also then automatically excreted as it is. This is regarding why I am stressing this point, because of in future you can get the in pharmacology diuretics. That's why I am so simple I am telling. So here in the loop of canal ascending, in the ascending loop of canal, have the one pump that is antiport, that is port is sodium potassium 2 chloride ions. It's very important. Along with already said that this is present in proximal convoluted, this is also it is a present loop of canal, but along with this sodium potassium 2 chloride ions pump it is present. So thing, this is the structure of distal convoluted tubules. This is a 25% filtrate. This is proximal convoluted tubules. This is loop of canal water, and this is thick ascending loop of canal up to here and thick ascending loop of canal. Next, distal tubules and collecting ducts. Reabsorption of here also sodium through the sodium potassium pump. Already we discussed regarding that. And S plus ion secreted. Here the more S plus ion secreted. And this is distal convoluted and collecting tubules. Here the more S plus ions secreted into the lumen. This is lumen. I think understand all of you. And also one more important distal convoluted is the hormone effect, that is antidiuretic hormone. That's also we can call as aldosterone. These aldosterone, when it is released, is more effect in the distal convoluted tubules. So what is that effect? When it is released aldosterone in the blood, reabsorption of sodium and water more takes place in the distal convoluted tubules. Enduku antidiuretic hormone annarante, enduku annarante, diuretic ante enti, urine ekku form avadu, kani idu em chestundi, మోర్ సోడియంని మోర్ వాటర్ని రీఅబ్జార్బ్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. దట్స్ వైట్ ఈస్ ఏ యాంటీడైరిటిక్ హార్మోన్. దాన్ని ఏమని ఉంటున్నాను, ఆల్డోస్టిరాన్. సో మోర్ రీఅబ్జార్ప్షన్ ఆఫ్ సోడియం వాటర్ ఇన్ టు ది బ్లడ్. దిస్ ఈజ్ లుమెన్. ఇక్కడికి వెళ్తున్నాయంటే ఎంటర్ ఇన్ టు ది బ్లడ్ డిస్టల్ కన్వర్టెడ్ ట్యూబుల్స్. వాట్ ఈస్ దట్? Already said that this is we discuss. This is interstitial tube. This is lumen. This is one cell, another cell. In the distal convoluted tubules, one pump is there. One pump. What is that pump? Is sodium chloride ion pump. Sodium chloride ion pump. This sodium chloride ion pump is reabsorption of sodium and
chlorine, reabsorption of sodium and chloride.
So these pump inhibited by diazide diuretics. So then when the sodium is not reabsorbed, then automatically water also not reabsorbed, then it will go as it easily go outside. So in this convoluted which pump it is present, carrier pump it is present is sodium and chloride. This is common, sodium, potassium, this is common in the proximal, distal and loopapineal. Okay. This is how it is happening. This is the diagrams which hands are, if it is the here in a distal convoluted tubules, reabsorption of their secreted potassium ions. And distal convoluted tubules, secretion of potassium ions and H plus ions. Already said that the H plus ions are secreted more in distal convoluted tubules and collecting ducts. Distal convoluted tubules and collecting ducts. But potassium ion more secreted only in collecting ducts. Only in collecting ducts. But here, at the end of the distal convoluted tubule and collecting ducts, the more potassium ions are secreted. More potassium ions are secreted, nothing but from the blood to blood fluid to lumen. This is a mechanism of aldosterone. We can discuss in future in the pharmacology. Then after that, whatever the formation of finally it is reached into the collecting duct. This is regarding the middle collecting ducts are reabsorbed than less 10% of the filtrated water and sodium. They are the final site of processing the urine and thereby play an extremely important role in determining the final urine output of water and solutes. The epithelial cells of the collecting ducts are nearly cuboidal in shape with a smooth surface and relatively few mitochondria, but in proximal convoluted tubules more mitochondria. So in the tubular secretion, so H plus, whatever the filtrated ions, H plus ions, potassium ions, creatinine and amino acids, these are secreted. Next, coming to the under regulation of renal physiology, mainly by the renin angiotensin system and aldosterone hormone and nervous system. These three mechanisms involved in the regulation of renal process. In the earlier class, already we discussed regarding that. This is the overall information regarding the renal physiology. So these are the references. And finally, thank you. All of you, note it down and submit your assignment as quickly as possible. Thank you.